Coming up, we're going to have a look on how you can leverage Azure as a single control plane using Azure Arc to manage, organize, and govern your hybrid cloud resources. I'm here with Leo, Cloud Solution Architect at Microsoft and the author of the Azure Arc Jumpstart. Hi, Leo. Obviously, we want to leverage Azure as a control plane for our resources inside Azure, but also for our resources on-premises, in other cloud providers, and even at edge locations. You know that Azure Arc can do that. Can you tell me a little bit more about that?
Yeah, of course. Thanks for having me, Thomas. So, you know, everything in Azure represented inside a resource provider. And a resource provider is basically the connection between a unit of resource into our control plane, which is Azure Resource Manager. So when you're using Azure and you're deploying a virtual machine or a storage account or a virtual network, any resource for that matter, you are leveraging a resource provider behind the scene. Now, with Azure Arc, what we did, we created resource providers for resources that are deployed outside of Azure. So in that way, you can basically project resources that are deployed outside of Azure, and those resources will have the same look and feel as first-class native Azure resources, and that's what we're going to show today.
Oh, that sounds pretty cool. Because I got a lot of requests, obviously, when we talk to customers, especially when we talk to their cloud architects and their IT teams, but obviously they want to leverage that. And you're telling me basically I can now simply connect my resources outside of Azure and basically use Azure Arc to bridge resources into the Azure control plane. So that sounds pretty cool.
Exactly. And what I want to show you today is the differences, how things look like with and without Azure. So I'm here in my Azure portal, and as you can see, I have a resource group, and that's a standard resource group. If you are using Azure, you know that you're deploying resources, everything go into a resource group, and those resources are represented as objects, and that's what you see here. So what we see here is a pretty straightforward resource group. We have a couple of virtual machines, we have some virtual networks, disks. We also have a Kubernetes cluster using Azure Kubernetes Service. Again, pretty standard stuff. What we're talking about today is how is that going to look like when you're going to start projecting Azure Arc resources. So I'll switch to the same resource group, but with the different filter. And what you can see here that I'm showing Azure Arc resources in addition to the native Azure resources that I already have. So if you will look here, you can see that I have a couple of Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes clusters. I have 4 Azure Arc enabled servers and 1 Azure Arc enabled SQL server. And as you can see, everything looks the same. There's no different when it comes to the presentation of these resources in Azure. So it's very easy to see. And if you're thinking about that from an IT ops perspective, what he's getting is the same view that he used to with his native Azure resources, but now he can also start looking at the resources that he projected as Azure Arc resources. So there's no need to change your view and everything is on the same place.
It's not just like installing an agent and then there is some metadata going up and that's it, right? It really becomes a native Azure resource and it's integrated into the Azure Resource Manager. So is there a way you can show me that a little bit? I mean, can I just use that in the Azure portal in the UI, or is there also for me like a way that I can do that using APIs and command line?
Yeah, great question. So if I will go to one of the Azure Arc enabled servers resources that I have, you can see that this resource have the same look and feel as an Azure VM. There's no difference when it comes to how it's being represented in the Azure portal. You can also see that in this resource, I applied some tags. That virtual machine that I deployed was actually on my VMware vSphere environment. And what I did, I projected that server as an Arc server. So I also added some tags here. Now, tags are very important because they represent the metadata, they are used to organize your resources, and you can actually query against these tags as you are managing your environment at scale. So what I want to show you is how you can leverage Azure Resource Graph, for example, as a first-class service that we have against projected Azure Arc resources. And for that, I created 3 queries here, and those are very simple queries. Let's open one of those queries and see what we have. you can see that in this query, I'm actually looking at the tags. So if you remember, I had hosting platform tag, and I also had the environment tag. So in this query, what I'm doing, I'm querying against hosting platform. So I want to see what type of hosting platform my Azure Arc enabled servers I'm currently configured against, and in which environment they are deployed. Is it on my dev environment or my production environment? So if I run here the query, what we will see is I'm getting three Azure Arc enabled servers. So that query is basically the same thing that I would have done on a Azure VM. So you can see that there's no difference. So if we're going back to the IT ops from API representation, there's no chain. That's the same tool chain. It's the same resource that you are used to and the same methodologies that you're used to in order for you to manage your environment. So that's pretty neat.
Okay, now this is really cool. And definitely the tagging part really helps me if I'm in IT operations or even if I do security and compliance to actually get an overview about what is going on, what resources do I have. It helps me to do inventory and discovery and basically get a full picture of my environment. Now, another question I get a lot is, now obviously we saw that Azure Arc can help me to basically get that visibility and obviously see what is going on in my environment. I can quickly get a list of all the resources, again, not just in Azure, but also in our hybrid cloud and multi-cloud environment. I also want to do things with this. I also want to make sure, for example, if I speak to security and compliance, they, for example, want to make sure that their systems are configured in a secure way and that they are actually compliant with their organizational standards and so on. So can you show me how we can actually use Azure Arc to do that?
Right. And, you know, security, compliance, governance are one of the biggest topics that we are talking about in the context of Azure Arc. Obviously, the need to do security, compliance, and governance at scale is critical for organizations. And I'm happy that you raised that question, because as part of us treating Azure Arc-enabled resources as first-class citizens inside the Azure ecosystem and inside our APIs, as you saw with Resource Graph, we're also able to apply Azure policies on these Azure Arc-enabled resources, right? And in what I want to show you here is, in Azure policy, I can go into definition. And if I look for a cert, for example, you can see here that I have a bunch of Azure policies. And if I'll go to the second one, you can see that this policy is with type of guest configuration. Now, the guest configuration policy is a unique policy to Azure Arc-enabled servers, because what you can do is you can apply a policy, Azure policy, on a resource that is an Azure Arc-enabled, in this case, Azure Arc-enabled server. Now, if you're talking about that with the context of security, compliance, governance, and all that, you can see here that this specific policy talks about the expired days of a certificate. But because that server is projected as an Azure Arc-enabled server, I can do that at scale. So that means that every server that I will onboard into my Azure environment, whether on the on the subscription level or on the resource group level, I can apply policy on these resources, and this policy will start doing its thing, will start do the remediation. So that means that the server, in this case, will always be in compliance with the organization standards. So again, that's another example of how we are taking advantage of an Azure service, which is Azure policy, against an Azure Arc-enabled server that is deployed, obviously, outside of Azure.
No, this is awesome. Again, you showed me so many cool stuff. You basically showed me how we can actually bridge resources outside of Azure. Doesn't matter if they're running on-premises, in the local data center, at edge locations, or even at other cloud providers, into the Azure control plane, make them a native Azure resource, and use Azure and the Azure management tools to basically get an inventory, get visibility, get control over these resources. So this is pretty fantastic. Now, I know that obviously people are now very interested in Azure Arc and how they can leverage Azure Arc for their servers and Kubernetes clusters and many other resources. So Leroy, where do people go if they want to learn more?
Yeah, so we have a lot of technical resources when it comes to Azure Arc. The first resource that you want to look at is the Azure Arc Jumpstart project. The Azure Arc Jumpstart project will give you off-the-shelf scenarios so you can start getting your hands dirty with Azure Arc in an automated fashion. We have a lot of scenarios to offer you, so please go ahead and check this out. The second resource that we have is Microsoft Learn. We created a lot of learning modules when it comes to Azure Arc, step-by-step, really from introduction to an expert level in Azure Arc models. And the third resource is the tech communities. The tech communities are a great place to look when you want to see the latest announcements that we have around Azure Arc, people from the community coming and writing technical blogs on Azure Arc. And really, it's just a great place to share knowledge. So I highly recommend it.
Thank you very much, Lior. This was really great. And for everyone watching, if you want to know more about building hybrid and multi-cloud architectures, check out the Cloud Adoption Framework and the Azure Architecture Center.